Deep Ellum. On air. Only the best in local music.
Do it live!
DFW and beyond. Deep Ellum on air! Mind control!
And lunatics thinking they can run for president. Reality stars thinking they're heaven sent. Irrelevant.
We're back live here on Mind Control for October. What day is today?
This is Oktoberfest.
October 8th. Episode 22.
22, Emmett Smith. In honor of rest in peace, Emmett Smith.
He's still alive, I think.
Thank you for all the memories.
Did he die whenever he joined the Cardinals? Was that the end of his life?
That's when he died to me.
Yep. Could you hear he was crying in that locker room when he played the Cowboys?
I don't hear anything about Emmitt Smith.
No. He won Dancing with the Stars, didn't he?
I did hear that.
Aren't you a big P1 of that show?
Wow. No.
No.
I'm a big P1 of this show.
Okay.
This is America's favorite alt podcast. I'm coining that phrase right now. Jedi, have you ever heard the phrase alt podcast?
Nope.
Come on, I just coined it right now.
I like it.
We're America's favorite alt podcast. Suck my dick.
Is there any other alt podcasts out there you want to name?
There's nobody else who has the balls to be alt podcast.
Sure.
We're so alt, nobody else is going to follow.
There's the Control Alt Delete podcast.
But that doesn't count.
No, no.
Totally different meanings, different inflections on the A.
Do you ever run that task manager and those programs that are not responding?
I do. I have to do that with my Mac because things freeze up.
But that's Apple Delete, right?
Mm-hmm. Task Manager.
Yep.
Oh, yes. You speak my language.
Yeah.
Eddie called me today, earlier today.
I did?
Yeah, Eddie called me and let me know. He told me that the guy from Ebola, not from Ebola, but the guy died from Ebola.
Oh, yeah.
He goes, hey, did you hear the guy died from Ebola?
Yeah.
I go, oh my God, what band is that? I haven't heard any of their stuff. Is there any good? I don't know them. I'm not familiar with their catalog.
Did the guy die from acute asphyxiation?
Like, I don't know.
The lead singer of NXS?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Erotic asphyxiation?
Yeah, like David Carradine.
Mm-hmm. Like all the greats?
Uh-huh.
I don't think that's how he died. So the guy died from Ebola.
Yeah, they gave him that experimental test medicine. And
we were so American cocky that we were going to save his life.
Yep.
And he died under our care. Jesse Jackson came to see the guy.
Yeah.
And that didn't inspire him. Instead, that killed him.
Uh-huh.
Can you believe it?
That Rambo Coalition.
And Jesse Jackson, I heard, tried to get some of his blood to smear all over himself.
Did you hear Jesse Jackson was saying that he didn't get service because he was black? That's what Jesse Jackson was saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You think there's some truth to that? Or maybe it was just because we hate him for having lied and come over here under false pretenses and infecting the entire city of Dallas with his Ebola.
Should he have been executed on terrorist charges?
And vomiting all over the fucking parking lot of his apartment?
Yeah.
This guy, come on.
He was either he had Ebola or he was anorexic, one of the two, right? Well, I guess he died, so he probably had Ebola.
Could have been anorexia, you never know.
Was he purging his meals?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
I can't wait for the sequel. I heard it was...
Oh, yeah.
Even bigger and better than the first.
The Purge Ebola.
We're about to find out. We'll talk about that sequel to the fucking Ebola guy here coming up pretty soon.
Yeah. What else happened this past week, Jer?
Well, Nicolas Cage's Left Behind movie, did it actually come out or just let critics see it?
No, it debuted in theaters. It opened wide this past Friday.
Left Behind based on the, best-selling Christian book series.
Yeah, Kirk Cameron produced a Christian version of the movie.
The Christian version? I heard this is more like a documentary version.
Was it?
It was more realistic because the number one biggest thing that they left behind was the script.
Oh.
So they just kind of rolled with the punches and,
just whatever happened in that Kirk Cameron movie, we did it.
Whatever Nicolas Cage gets on film.
You can't.
We're releasing it.
You can't script that.
Immediately.
Hey, did y'all read any of the Left Behind books?
No.
No? Did you?
Read them all.
Really?
Yeah.
As a Christian or as a...
Yeah.
Really?
Uh-huh.
I've never read any of them.
Yeah.
Are they good? Did you like Kirk Cameron's performance in the movies? Did you see the movies?
Yeah, I saw the movies. I mean, it was okay. But, I mean, the books were actually really good.
How many were there?
God, like 20.
Wow.
Yeah, there's a lot.
Kurt Cameron didn't write those books, though.
No, it was Tim LaHaye and some other guy, Dr. Somebody.
Hmm.
But the last book, like, to me, like, even when I was a Christian then, the last book is somewhat blasphemous because they have, like, actual Jesus, and he's, like, chilling with everyone that was, like, left behind, and it's, like,
what?
Taking some, you know, I mean...
Sure, yeah, taking some liberties with the Bible there.
It's like,
so they got Jesus just kind of hanging around, like, it's Black Jesus, the TV show.
Yeah, he comes out, and he, like, basically kicks everyone's ass that was one of the bad guys and throws them in the pit.
Battle of Armageddon.
And he talks to everybody, like, through... telepathy
through Jesus speak.
And then he's just like all cool and chill, and he's like, hey guys, how y'all doing?
Wow.
Huh.
Was he voted president of the new world? No.
He takes over the whole world, man. Oh,
yeah, that's how it goes, right?
Yeah. They have supposed to be 1,000 years on earth, right? And then we'll go to heaven. Why 1,000 years on earth?
I always wondered that too, because they say the devil is thrown into the abyss for 1,000 years, and then what? What happens after that?
Yeah, there's a lot of loopholes in this.
Is there a new devil that comes around?
I don't know.
No?
We'll find out.
I guess it's like in Dragon Ball Z, he just keeps leveling up. He's even meaner.
Well, that's probably what does happen. He's going to level up and find us in heaven, and it's a whole new battle.
The battle in heaven, right?
Can't wait for it. Nicolas Cage will star in that version as well. Nicolas Cage.
Is he paying off some back taxes? Is that why he's in so many movies?
Man,
I heard he has some kind of debt.
I think he's just accepted the fact that he's going to make ridiculous movies and be ridiculous Nicolas Cage.
Yeah.
And live it up. I mean, when I saw him make fun of himself on Saturday Night Live, I figured he's in on the joke, and still making the joke on himself.
What's the last Nick Cage movie you saw?
Oh, I'm actually a big fan of these. I watched these.
Joe, did you see Joe? I heard Joe was good.
No, I started watching it. I didn't finish it for no other reason than laziness. I need to watch. I'd watch that. I saw the one, you know, I saw Bad Lieutenant. I've seen.
Okay. Did you see The Knowing?
I watched 8mm recently because I didn't watch it, you know, back in the day as a kid.
You see any of those?
I wasn't into Machine as a kid.
No.
Making snuff films.
Uh-huh.
But as an adult, I definitely am.
What was that Constitution movie he made?
Oh, National Treasure type thing? No, I didn't see any of those.
No.
I saw Night at the Museum instead. I think it was either or.
Face Off was probably his best movie. People love that Leaving Las Vegas or whatever, where he's the alcoholic.
Mm. But he specializes in this, you know, he's the lone guy that's got to go after this group, or he's got to uncover this one thing. He's always a cop, or he's always a... gangster, mobster, tough guy.
Some kind of whacked out conspiracy theorist who's fighting the end of the world in that movie, The Knowing. You ever see The Knowing? Where he figured out the numbers like lead to terrorist events.
Knowing. Oh my God, that was terrible.
He was good in Kick-Ass.
Yeah?
He was?
Yeah, he was.
He was in there?
Yeah, he was.
He played the Batman character, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll have to revisit that.
It was all right.
Yeah.
I've seen Kick-Ass. It's been a while. I need to see Kick-Ass too. I want to see Jim Carrey in whatever that
was. Sergeant Slaughter or whatever.
That looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
State Fair of Texas.
Aren't you going to the State Fair tonight?
I'm going there directly there after the show to join my family, my wife and 2 children.
Yeah. Are they on the Ferris wheel as we speak?
Mm-hmm. They're up at the top. The children are crying. Nina's wishing I was there.
Yeah.
Instead, I'm doing this.
Hey, if you keep driving past the fair just a little bit, it's $5 parking.
It's a good tip.
Yep. Just keep going just a little bit. I mean, you're still right in front of the fairground, so it's not like you're having to walk really far. It's just the last parking guy.
At the fair.
It's $10 everywhere else, but $5 at the last guy. And not only that, but he's got like really cool lights with the big arrow like pointing in.
I like that.
How's this guy not like making a killing?
I like that.
Hey.
He is $5 at a time.
Yeah.
That equals a killing.
Undercutting.
Yeah. Well, when you're that far away, you're not undercutting anything.
That's true.
Maybe he was the closest thing to the fair trying to undercut, but...
Do you think he's giving an Ebola discount?
He's just trying to get his family, you know...
Back to Liberia.
Exactly.
Yep.
Yeah, he also drives a cab the minute the parking lot closes down.
Yeah.
It's really sad existence. But, you know, if you're into the fair, get out there.
Lots of good food at the fair, right?
Lots of good food. I don't know if you heard this. Did you hear the new fried? That, you know, there's always something big fried.
Snickers and beer, yeah.
Mm-hmm, in the past. Yeah, this year it's fried Ebola.
Oh, you can get fried Ebola?
Dallas specialty.
On a stick? Absolutely.
Yeah, fried Ebola on a stick or boneless. Okay. They offer it to you either way, but the bread crust is actually really, really good.
Using the charred remains of Thomas Duncan.
Mm-hmm. They won. I don't know if you actually heard this. It was just released on the Observer Twitter feed.
Oh, yeah.
They won a blue ribbon for the best fried virus.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. It was good. Leprosy was up there.
Yeah.
But Ebola won out. So I think it was obviously.
This is the year of Ebola, right?
It's the hot topic. Yeah. Everybody, I think on the Chinese calendar, it is the year of Ebola.
Oh, is it?
So I saw all this coming.
Did Ebola kill the dog or the bull, whatever it is, the dragon?
Mm-hmm. The cock?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I think Ebola ate the year of the cock.
Hmm.
And now it's the year of Ebola.
What else is going on in the world, Jer?
Yeah. Near and dear to our hearts, the Dallas Cowboys will be playing the Seattle, what are they now, the Supersonics?
I think they're still the Seahawks.
Okay, so the Seattle Seahawks will be taking on the Dallas Cowboys this Sunday.
Do you think the Cowboys should add an accent neon color to their uniform like the Seahawks did with that neon green?
Mm-hmm.
Blue?
No, it's the worst decision ever. Oh, they're lucky that they're good, because if it wasn't for that, they wouldn't get away with those stupid jerseys.
I like the neon accent.
They're ridiculous colors.
Yeah.
No, their whole green color scheme is way wrong in every way.
Tampa Bay's new uniforms are probably the worst in the league, though, right?
Sure.
They just added that shoulder color, I guess. Yeah.
The new Oklahoma, was that their road uniform, that red thing? That was weird a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
But, so, listen, big announcement. Jedi even actually just let me know about this before the show. We got the funding. We, as a show, are going to donate, for every first quarter fumble from DeMarco Murray, $1,000 to St. Jude's Children's Hospital. So, you know, DeMarco, just...
keep on fumbling, yeah.
Keep on fumbling like you've been doing.
Yeah.
And we, you know, this is actually going straight to the kids with cancer.
Yeah, pediatric cancer, right?
Pediatric cancer. So
So if you support pediatric cancer, you should definitely fumble the ball to DeMarco.
Definitely. Do you hear the kids laughing already?
Yep.
They already feel the money coming. It's beautiful. Kids.
You're going to get some money.
At least 1,000. He's been dropping at least one. I think with this promotion, he might drop 2 or 3. I'm not gonna guarantee anything, but I think.
And also, if he fumbles twice, DeMarco's, your pizzas are half price at Papa John's the next
that's
day.
That's right. That's yep. right. Any more than 4 fumbles.
Yeah.
You can put in the promo code.
Cancer.
Cancer on Papa John's on
Monday. After
Monday
the game?
Morning.
Yeah.
And Eddie will deliver the pizza to you. Sure. It's only in the Dallas area.
Pantsless.
Yes.
Yep.
Erect.
It's never erect.
Half erect.
Okay.
Okay, so, listen. We have a show to do. This is episode 22.
Yeah.
We're here. We're back to full power. Jedi's here running the show. It's been a number of weeks.
Yeah, it has.
I think, how many weeks did Kat just destroy the show with?
Well, she did the last two, and then I did one, and then she did the one before.
Aha, and then it was a lot of Rodney. Yeah. That's why I feel like I haven't seen you forever, because... You've been so busy. Jedi's a very busy guy.
Yep.
Busting those cheaters.
And Dallas media. And he has things to do on Wednesday nights when he's not with us, believe it or not. So, anyway, back at full force. Here we are, episode 22.
Yep.
And Eddie, what is the first thing on your mind?
So, you know, there's been lots of talk about North Korea.
It's North Korea.
I don't know if you've seen
the first thing on your mind is North Korea.
Sure. Is Kim Jong-un president, or is he still dictator, or what?
What is going on in your mind that that's the number one thing on your mind?
So, with the North Korean leader, Kim Jong-un, not seen in public for more than a month, rumors of a palace coup are rife. But evidence from inside the country suggests otherwise. The speculation stems from remarks from a former high-ranking North Korean official turned defector, Jang Jin-sung.
The benefactor? Like,
no, he's
Mark
a,
Cuban's old
he's
show?
A defactor.
Oh.
Yeah. He suggested the OGD had seized control, leaving Kim as a figurehead. Based on video evidence of his limp, it is widely accepted that Kim is now receiving medical treatment. So I guess...
Whoa.
Yeah.
He has Ebola?
No, he has a limp. I heard it's gangrene that he has.
Like he has something wrong with his lip?
A limp.
Oh, a limp.
Yeah.
Oh, so like he's, you know... Well, hey, come on, Kennedy. You know, he fought through everything.
Yeah.
Who was our president? FDR was in a wheelchair?
Yeah.
Who was in a wheelchair?
Yeah, FDR, yeah.
Come on.
Greg Abbott also was in a wheelchair.
Greg Abbott, he's doing it.
Yeah.
Everybody's doing it. Get in a wheelchair and fucking run your country, North Korea.
So despite the rumor mill, the North Korean message...
He's a young kid. I don't know.
...is still of Kim's malevolent greatness. In elite circles, his authority may be fragile, but that is a different question. One of the distributions of... whatever. It should not be...
Isn't he a deity?
Yeah, deities can't get gangrene, can they?
No, deities can't get gangrene. When's the last time Jesus got gangrene?
What, didn't Bobby Hill get gangrene?
You remember when Mary Magdalene gave him herpes, though?
Yeah, and then he cured it? She cured it?
Yep, he's the first known case to be cured by herpes, because she washed it with her hair.
Oh, yeah, with her
hair? That's the Bible story they don't tell you.
With her pubic hair?
That's right.
Yep.
That's right.
And her sweet, sweet body fluids.
Mmm.
Yeah.
Mmm. Makes me think of Ebola all over again. Get your Friday Ebola at the State Fair of Texas.
Yep. So,
hey, do y'all think I can kick Kim Jong-un's ass?
You could?
Like, do you think you could? Like,
I know I could.
I couldn't.
Yeah.
You don't think you could?
No.
I feel like I could.
He has that leverage advantage, right?
He can't be more than 3 feet, right?
I don't think so. With the bad leg even, I think he could still kick my ass.
You think even with gangrene, he would out-wrestle you?
Yeah.
Maybe he's got that natural power?
That deity power,
no,
yeah.
No, you're a big guy. You could fall on him. You could you could do a lot. I imagine a fight between you guys would be like a sumo fight. You just kind of like...
push each other.
Yeah, it'd be pretty good. A lot of meat slapping.
Okay. I'm down for that.
Yeah. Eddie and Kim Jong-un.
Yeah.
So somebody else is running that country. I mean, there's no way those people over there can truly believe that he's a deity. He's running the country. They got to know what's up and they're just pretending, right? Like when you see them crying and they're going... ballistic over him and they love him so much, they can't be for real.
No, there's guns pointed to their heads and forcing them to do that, right?
Yeah.
So when these guys finally get free in North Korea, what do you think is the most like shocking thing that they're gonna, you know, come across when they see the real world?
Dennis Rodman having married Carmen Electra? Probably.
They already know that. They're like,
do they?
Yeah, they're fans of Dennis Rodman. They're like, they know, they have like a biography of the guy.
All they're allowed to have are his basketball tapes.
I heard they got a new iPhone over there in North Korea, their own version of the iPhone.
Is Amazon Fire, is it so bad they had to go sell it in North Korea?
No, I think it's some offshoot of a Chinese company that produced a phone just for North Korea with, you know, with internet restrictions and phone call restrictions.
So they did it
texting
right.
Texting restrictions, yeah.
Great. Yep. Well,
I'm sorry. Am I supposed to run this like the whole time? Because I don't know. This music?
Yeah.
You can.
Yeah, if you don't mind. Okay. Can we get it a little bit turned down? Yeah. I feel like I have to yell over it. Exactly. Yeah, if there's any way to loop it, or you just have to keep.
Yeah, I just got to keep.
Nah, it sucks.
It's all right. I'll figure it out.
Everybody loves it. We got so many emails this week. Everybody was demanding the music during the news, so.
Yeah. It's all just, those tweets.
They were saying, please talk about North Korea first.
Uh-huh.
For some reason, that's what Eddie was worried about. Kim Jong-un.
But he's not really, you know...
He better not lose power. He can't lose power. You know why he's staying in power?
Why is
because
that?
Because that Seth Rogen movie hasn't come out yet.
Oh, that's right.
What is that one?
You know, To Kill a North Korean or something.
Yeah. Him and James Franco went to the trouble of making this whole movie.
Right.
And then he even hyped it up for them by, you know, threatening to kill America if this movie came out.
Yeah.
And now you're telling me he's not empowered. I guarantee that they're going to at least keep this going for the promotional campaign.
Yeah.
He's going to at least go on Leno. We can't do Leno anymore. Let's do Fallon. He'll do...
Yeah.
Maybe he'll do Stern.
Or the North Korean version of Stern and Leno.
Hey, did y'all see Stern on Letterman?
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. It's one of the greatest interviews Letterman has ever done.
Did he just do it?
Yeah, I think it was last night. I was watching it just an hour ago. It's like 20 minutes long. It is greatness. Y'all should check it out. I'm a huge Stern fan, so.
Yeah, look at it.
Did they talk about this being Letterman's last year?
You know what? I didn't even finish the interview, so I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm sure they had to harp on that.
Lots of late night shakeups. Craig Ferguson is done.
Listen to my prediction right now.
Yeah.
I'm going to predict right now that Letterman will have Howard Stern on his last show ever.
I would guess my prediction. Joan Rivers probably gonna be his last guest.
Eddie.
What?
Oh my God! Do you not know?
Do I not know what?
John Rivers is dead, dude.
No, say it's not true.
Hmm.
So Breaking news. Thomas Duncan died from Ebola today. Very sad news, like we talked about earlier in the show.
Yes, we mentioned this guy.
Yeah. But unfortunately...
I just want to take a moment to be glad
to kill that, my transition.
Yeah, I just want to take a moment and say I'm glad that Ebola's done. Dallas is clean.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
This guy died, and with him, he took Ebola to hell. And now, we're all safe to go about our business.
No, Ebola is not done yet. Just like a bad movie sequel, it's back, and it's attacking Frisco, it seems like.
Oh. Where's Frisco? I just know Dallas. I'm from New York.
You know, it's around Dallas.
I'm from California. What's around Dallas?
I think it's northwest or northeast or something.
Hmm.
You know, the Rangers have that ballpark out there, Dr. Pepper ballpark.
Yes, and the Cowboys are moving their training facility there.
You think it's only a matter of time before...
Every Dallas Cowboy member has Ebola?
That's not what I was going for, but
we saw the pictures from the night Jerry got Ebola from those strippers.
Yeah.
They weren't even hot, those girls. That was the weird part to me.
Ebola tears you up.
That's a whole other story.
Yeah. So, yeah, news broke today after that guy died that Ebola wasn't done yet. A suburban Dallas official say a Dallas County sheriff's deputy who had gone into the apartment where the first U.S. Ebola patient had stayed is hospitalized after falling ill.
Say it ain't so.
Emergency responders in the Dallas suburb took the deputy to the hospital after an urgent care facility reported a patient exhibiting signs of and symptoms of Ebola.
After he goes to care now.
Yeah, you wouldn't go to care now? You probably called 911 if you had Ebola?
If I thought I had Ebola, the last thing I would think about doing is going to care now.
Exposing all those people to Ebola.
What? Is there something about when you get Ebola, it makes you retarded?
I think so.
Because every single person with Ebola has seemed to do something retarded.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, oh, did you come in contact with anybody? I don't know. I mean, I did rub my privates on school children, so... But I don't think that...
Well, this guy that came over from Liberia, like, he helped some dying woman from Ebola over in Liberia. Yeah.
And then he came over here and told everybody he was fine, and he vomited all over his parking lot.
Yeah.
He obviously vomited all over this deputy, who now has it.
He was even around the deputy whenever.
So, answer the question right now. Did that deputy get this because it's airborne?
I don't think so.
Do you think it could have been maybe they picked up his remote? Because don't they say in a hotel room, the dirtiest thing full of semen is a remote? Maybe this guy's remote was just like...
He wanted to watch some Game of Thrones.
Caked with Ebola.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's come so many times from watching incest on Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
And ever since he got to America, that's all he heard about.
Was that Game of Thrones incest stuff. Mm-hmm. And so the Dallas sheriff had to see the same thing, right? He had to see it.
It's not like he came on his remote. He came in his hand and it just, you know, maybe he even forgot it was on there and it dried up a little bit.
Right.
Grabbed his remote to turn the volume up now that he was done.
Right. Watch some ESPN or something.
Right.
Yeah.
And next thing you know, deputy comes in there and goes, hey.
I need to watch some Game of Thrones.
You guys think there's anything on this? No? Okay. Yeah. Ebola.
Yeah.
Got it.
So that poor deputy, he probably doesn't even have Ebola, though, right?
To be fair, it's still speculated, but we OJ watched him. We followed him all the way down the highway.
In that white Bronco?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To make sure that he got to the hospital. I don't know what the motivation in watching the ambulance is. I tweeted out a picture of an ambulance earlier now, because every ambulance I see, I assume somebody with Ebola is in it.
Yeah.
I mean, we live in Dallas, the Ebola capital of the world, so...
Would it have been wheels off if that ambulance doors fell open and he just fell out of the stretcher?
Did
onto
you
the,
say
the
fallopian?
Freeway? Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Is it true that if you lick a fallopian, you get cancer?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what I heard.
Absolutely.
HPV. So, also, in other news, other things are happening in the world besides Ebola, Jared.
I can't believe it, but go on.
So in Ferguson, protesters demonstrated outside a St. Louis Cardinals game at Busch Stadium on Tuesday for a second night in a row, demanding justice after the death of an unarmed 18-year-old in the St. Louis suburb of Ferguson.
They're still mad about this?
Yeah.
Haven't they ever heard of forgive and forget? Are any of them Christians?
Turn the other cheek,
Are they going to turn the other cheek any day now?
So one witness to the protest said, "I don't understand why they're here." And then she said, Wilson, I mean, so this is more of the article. Susan Wilson, a waitress who lives in Ferguson, Missouri, was watching about 20 protesters gathered outside Busch Stadium. Wilson said she wasn't bothered by their presence, but said she didn't understand why they chose to show up at the game.
That's got to be Busch Stadium, as in like Anheuser-Busch, right?
Uh-huh, yeah.
All right, well, I'm on their side.
Yeah. And so some of these protesters were quoted as saying, "We are down at Busch Stadium because our motto is no justice, no peace. If there's no justice, this town won't get any peace. Why should everybody go on with their everyday life as if nothing is going on? We will continue to disrupt their baseball games, their operas, their church events, etc. until we get justice for Mike Brown and all the other unarmed black men killed by police in the United States."
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. That sounds scary.
Yeah. So
that sounds threatening.
Yeah, no justice, no peace, right? You see they interrupted that opera this past weekend? That flash mob?
You know there was nothing but people, white people in that one, right?
Oh, yeah, there was nothing but white people, yeah.
Absolutely. Their baseball games.
Oh, yeah. Isn't that a little bit weird that she was using that terminology? Their baseball games, their operas.
What do you think she meant by that?
White people, right?
Yeah. I don't know. Let's not put words in her mouth.
She's putting words into policemen's mouths, right? Like, they're just out there killing unarmed black men, right? Like that's the job of the cops, right?
I can't believe I hear you talking like this. I think these protests over the weeks have worn you down. You sounded, when this first happened, you were all about it.
You know, obviously I'm against, you know, police brutality, excessive force, you know. But,
Is that obvious?
It may not be obvious to some people, but...
I think people watching at home think you love police brutality.
Oh, yeah. So, you know, just weird, there's rumors of riots breaking out if this David Wilson, or Darren, it is Darren Wilson, isn't charged with murder. So the FBI is gearing up for riots over there.
If he's not convicted of murder?
Or not not charged, yeah.
Wow.
Yep. And he's not going to be charged.
I can see that. I mean, honestly, that's what I would be doing. If I was a young African-American living in St. Louis,
yeah,
in the area, I'd probably go out there and just fuck shit up.
Yeah.
Because it does need to be fucked up, right? Because their situation is fucked up.
Sure, you just, you know, like, I hope that this type of stuff would have been fixed years ago.
And if they're not going to go out and do these games, and they're not going to do this stuff, then what was any of it for, right?
Exactly.
If you were just going to come out there when the cameras were there, and whenever it was kind of sexy thing to talk about,
right?
Then you were wasting your time. But if you're serious, and you want to disrupt, the games and operas,
yeah,
and you want to really hold up, you know, normal everyday life, and until people...
That's part of it, right?
That's what I'm down for. Let's get serious.
The riots, not so much, but you know, interrupting, you know, stupid events while this stuff's going on is okay by me.
That's why I'm team John Wiley Price around here, who's been indicted for all this horse shit, you know, taking money, this and that, blah, blah, blah. Why people don't like him, because the only thing he wants to talk about is how black people are being...
He was also speaking out. He was speaking out with Jesse Jackson yesterday about this Ebola guy not being seen when he first came into the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Them trying to dump the patient off is what they were saying.
Yeah. Well, man. The minute I heard that African accent, I would have put him right into quarantine. Uh-huh. If I heard an African accent, I'm going to assume Ebola.
Yeah.
I hate to tell you that right now, but that's what I would do. I would put him right in a bubble room.
Do you want to christen Africa new Ebola?
Yeah. You said it, not me, but I might go with that.
Yeah.
New Ebola. I don't know. If you could give me like a cool tagline, we might be able to sell this.
I can't think of one.
New Ebola, where?
Where do you get blood ulcers that pop and kill you?
Yeah. The bleed from your eyes state. The internal bleeding...
Until you die state.
State.
Yeah.
I know it's a country, but state sounds best.
Sure. You know, we're the Lone Star State,
right? Did I say country?
Yeah, you did.
I meant continent.
Oh,
yeah. I'm incompetent.
Yeah. I think we all are as Americans. We don't really focus on geography too much here in the U.S., right?
Mm-hmm. So, new Ebola.
Yep.
But is this new? That's what I'm wondering. How long has Ebola been going rampant over there?
You see that meme picture people have been posting with black children dancing over in Africa, you know, because white people now have Ebola, so that is going to be a cure, you know?
But white people don't have Ebola. Is that guy white? Do we know any white people that have Ebola yet?
This deputy probably is white.
Well, the people in Spain, too. Yeah. It's going crazy.
The people in Atlanta were white.
Oh, yeah, those doctors, yeah.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that was when it was really sad, when it was about white people. I was really sad about that.
But they got fixed up real quick, huh?
Thank God.
Yeah.
You know, I think it might have been something in their blood. I don't want to be controversial, but...
you think it was genetic?
It is funny that they let this guy die, and then those white people came over here, and they were like... Number cured one, they fucking days. Walked in the hospital pretty much right. cured.
Swagging. Yeah.
They did. They walked into the hospital like pretty much untouched, and then walked out the next day like, nah, I got an IV, and
watched the
game.
Yeah.
They told me I could check out last night, but I thought, nah, I better catch some Z's.
Get that hospital food.
Mm-hmm. I like that breakfast. I want to see what they had for breakfast. I want to see the hash browns were any good.
But I heard that they're going to kill that dog over there in Spain, right?
That's why I don't fear it.
A lot of people are freaking out over that dog.
I'm close enough to being white that I believe that they will give me the cure.
Wait, what's going on with the dog?
So there's a dog that, you know, was owned by that Spanish nursing assistant, and they want to kill the dog. Yeah. Yeah, and there's actually a petition online. I think 300,000 people signed
fuck
it.
Fuck you. For one dog, the dog needs to go. Everything in her room needs to go. Everything everywhere around her needs to go.
Just
that's
burn,
fine.
Burn the entire country down.
She's married. Her husband needs to go.
Yeah. His husband's the one fighting for this dog to survive.
Her husband's... Listen, if they can quarantine the husband, they can quarantine the dog.
Sure, that's what everyone's saying.
Put the fucking dog in there with the husband. Let him sit there for 2 weeks. That's when I'll be satisfied that it's okay, and then let them back into Spain.
Quarantine people in Dallas are going to come up with Ebola, do you think? Is that going to be full-on panic if you know, these people get it?
Well, this will be a hot story for the next 2 weeks as we wait to find out.
Maybe we can get some hits off of it, right?
One of them has already been cleared, I read this morning.
Good. Okay, good.
Yeah.
I don't know what to make of all this. I mean, I make fun of it. I really, the thought has crossed my mind. I go, I'm making fun of all this, but like, what if I go to the fair tonight?
Hey.
And someone in my family gets Ebola. And then how funny is all this going to be, Eddie?
You have to think about that whenever you're making the jokes too, right?
Usually I don't like to think.
Oh, okay. I think, you know, Ebola needs to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. You know, probably the death penalty, right?
That's a tough stance, but yeah.
Yeah. I'm usually anti-death penalty, but I think Ebola deserves it.
I think that's what Wendy Davis is running on, so you sound like a Democrat. You would probably...
Yeah.
You'd probably want to vote along her lines.
Yeah, I'm voting for that mole for sure. Yeah.
How many times have you released to that mole?
What do you mean released?
I'm not sure.
Like released Ebola patients from quarantine?
I'm not sure at this point.
Yeah.
How long are you going to be quarantined before they just give up and go? And what is quarantine? They quarantine these people because they were being difficult, right? They told them, don't leave your house, and they left their house, and they quarantined them.
I heard somebody donated one of their houses, like a property owner donated the house to the city of Dallas. Yeah.
Is there any way that house doesn't get burned down?
Are they going to burn this Ebola guy, or are they going to incinerate him? Or are they going to bury him, or what?
What do you do with that? You can't bury him and let Ebola get into the water source.
Yeah, you know, he did use the bathroom, though, whenever he was not diagnosed, so he definitely was... spreading Ebola all over
the
place.
Oh, when he wasn't diagnosed, you're right. Yeah. He was shitting into toilets and flushing it into the sewer system.
Yep.
Man, we are so fucked.
But hopefully, you know, the water purification stuff, you know, really gets
that stuff going. Am I ignorant here? Am I an ignorant American if I tell you I don't have a clue what Ebola is or does?
It's a virus, and it, you know, it's a lot like the flu, they said, except it causes that internal bleeding and... You get these kind of like welts on your body, like huge blood welts, they said, like hematomas or something.
How does it kill you?
Like the flu, whatever, just, you know, tears your body apart.
Nobody dies from the flu.
Sure they do. Whenever it's Ebolaized.
Swine flu people were scared of.
SARS, yeah.
So it's flu-like.
Yeah.
I'm not scared of the flu. I want to be scared of Ebola. That's what I'm saying. I want to be scared of this. But I'm really not scared of it.
Yeah. You work in a hospital, too, so there's a higher likelihood.
Yeah.
Luckily, these Ebola patients are going to Presby. So you and I don't have anything to worry about when it comes to that.
Yeah, I tell you, I wanted to get national news coverage.
Yeah.
I wound up walking around in front of that hospital where the Ebola guy died, holding up the sign, "I dare Ebola to get me."
Yeah, well, Ebola came to Dallas.
Ebola won't touch me.
Ebola came to Dallas looking for you.
I'd be the only guy in Dallas with the balls to stand up to Ebola. I could have been known for that, but we didn't have time, right?
You could be known for mind control.
I could be. So let's do that this week, I guess. Okay. Let's get known for that.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Don't you have some real meme news you want to go through?
Okay, let's debut this right here.
Yeah.
First and foremost, I want to tell everybody this is our new... I searched the internet for meme headlines.
Yeah.
I don't believe anybody is doing this. I believe that we are the only people that are making memes out of daily headlines, right?
Right, yeah.
Hot off the press, not just, you know, whatever comes to mind, but a news source only in meme format, right?
Yeah, we're the only ones dumb enough to do this, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So... I thought we'd go through, you know, some of the headlines.
Yeah.
You know, much like we do on the show, and do them in meme format.
Okay.
Starting with Michael Phelps. You heard he went to, he got a DUI?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Now he's what? Apologized, going to rehab, he's sorry.
Is he going to sensitivity training?
Probably.
Yeah.
That's all it is because he's Michael Phelps.
Yeah.
Right? Is that on screen?
Yeah.
So there you go. Michael Phelps gets a DUI, he's going to rehab. If I was to get a DUI, I'm going to get raped in prison, okay?
Did you get that image from Reddit?
I just Google image searched it.
No, but the meme thing, is that an official Reddit meme, or where did that come from?
The meme?
Uh-huh.
That's me.
Oh, that's you. You created that
image. Right. That's right. These are mind control originals.
Okay.
Based on the headlines, ripped from the headlines. Unlike SVU, where all the episodes are ripped from the headlines based on disgusting sexual acts.
You see, there's that episode coming up about the embattled basketball owner. Yeah, I had a tape leaked out there.
I hope the ending is that he's gay, because that's what Donald Sterling is.
Poor Michael Phelps.
Poor.
His career's over, right?
Poor Michael Phelps.
Do you think he can win another gold medal? With another DUI on his record?
I guarantee you he could. Listen, the guy could go out tomorrow and win a gold medal. Yeah. Okay? I say he's done enough for this country.
Yeah.
I don't think he needs to do one more thing. The officer that pulled him over should have looked at his license plate. Don't even look at his driver's license. Just...
Yeah.
You see, this is Michael Phelps.
You didn't get a personalized plate that said something about number one gold or something?
Go about your business, sir.
Yeah.
The officer should have apologized to him for even pulling him over.
Well, was it a alcohol DUI or a weed DUI?
Oh, it was alcohol. He was he was way over the limit, and he was driving about double the speed limit.
Like Rod Baronis?
But it doesn't matter. The difference is he's Michael Phelps, and he's won 8,000 gold medals for this country.
I think 8,000 may be overstating how many he won.
That's why any soldier who went over to Iraq or Afghanistan can come back and do anything they want.
Yeah.
You have to respect the, you know, history.
True.
You have to.
Have to.
That's why he gets to go to rehab, and I would get raped in prison.
Is it true, though, that you don't want to go to rehab? No, no, no?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, believe me, I tried to make a joke out of that.
I just did.
It just didn't happen.
Yeah.
I was going to let you work that out. Yeah. So, Jedi, besides Seventh Heaven, what else do I have over there? What are my headlines?
We got Jennifer Lawrence.
Okay, let's go Jennifer Lawrence, right? She got her fappening pictures put out there, her iPhone got leaked, and now all of a sudden you can see her...
You see she did that interview with Vanity Fair this week, though?
Boobs, you can see her everything. All her personal, private photos. And what, she did an interview and compared this to a sex crime.
It is, though, right? Yeah.
Jennifer Lawrence, her leaked nude sex pictures are a sex crime. But what is his name? Tavion or little Tarion? Fun to do bad things. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but it is. It's the world is a better place with Jennifer Lawrence news. Have you seen him, Jedi?
We haven't
got to talk with you about these.
No, I haven't, and I don't know who the little black kid is. What does this mean?
What did he do? He stole
his mom's car, right?
He stole his mom's car. It was a news story.
Yeah.
And they talked to him on the news, and that was his excuse for everything. It's fun to do bad things. What else was his big headline? It's fun to do bad things, and I don't know. He's a funny kid. But listen, my life is a much better world when I can easily access her pictures on Reddit.
So she said that because she's a celebrity doesn't mean that people have the right to, you know, invade her privacy and leak these pictures out.
Yeah, it does.
She said that having to tell her dad about this was, like, not worth all the money she's made on the Hunger Games.
Well, hey, how about you have not ever done that?
Right, then? How about you quit
Hollywood? I would let my mom take pictures of me naked for the money that she
to
got.
To be able to star in the Hunger Games? Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You're paying your debt. You show up. You just look hot. That's all we need you to do.
Yeah. But I guess she thinks she's, you know, some kind of, like, important person or something. You know, if she wants to quit Hollywood, plenty of actors have done it before, right? She can just leave and never be seen again. We'd probably be better off for it, wouldn't we?
How dare you talk about J-Law like that? So is it like a sex crime? I mean, did we rape her? I know I'm eye-fucking her right now, but...
Yeah.
Is that rape?
I think it's, you know, invasion of privacy, like...
But is it a sex crime? Is she even in the right vicinity by calling it sex crime?
Yeah, I think she is.
No, it's not a sex crime.
Thank you.
If you take an upskirt of a girl walking down the street, isn't that a sex crime?
Well, that is, but stealing someone's nude pic. I mean, how would they know that they were nude pics? They just, you know.
They just hacked in there and happened to find them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let me get this right. If she took the picture and she deleted it years ago and forgot all about it, they can still... They can see that?
Yeah, Apple backs up everything where it's pretty much impossible to delete.
Yeah, you bet they do.
Yeah.
So how many guys do you think are like...
Did you hear Nick Hogan had some pictures come out this past week?
I heard. I had no interest in seeing. Did you see these?
I didn't. I didn't want to break any sex crime laws, you know?
Oh, you're one of these that's scared?
Not scared. You know, has some self-respect, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I have none of that. But I still didn't want to see Nick... I'm saying...
Nick Hogan?
Nick Hogan's
dick.
No way. Maybe Nick Cannon.
Hey-o.
Nick Cannon, who, you know, is divorcing Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
Made headlines this week by getting...
It's always sad whenever a marriage ends, you know. It's against God, you know.
Really sad. Yeah. We all thought they were going to make it. Yeah. We all thought, you know, he was going to stand by her when she was 60 and he was 40. But,
He still probably died before her, though, right?
Nope, they're not going to make it. Yeah, he's got some sort of sickness.
Lyme disease or something.
Yeah, he's definitely following the Ebola guy very shortly. To hell. He'll be taking that Lyme disease to hell with him.
Yeah.
And anyway, so he got a tattoo cover-up. I don't know if you know this. He had Mariah written on the back of his back.
Uh-huh.
There he is with her. And he got it covered up with a nice little cross.
Man, did he get this Mariah tattoo done in fucking jail, man? Because that looks
it
awful.
It does look terrible, right?
Yeah.
He found the closest cholo and just said, hey, man... I think that was actually done with, what do they call it, the little stick and needle where they just kind of like pound you with it. No, that does look pretty, but I think that was the point.
It's off balance, right? It's not centered.
Yeah, it's not even even.
It's horrible. So I think he was covering it up more just from the shame of the tattoo than even just the name.
Do you think Jesus was pissed off that his image was used to cover up that tattoo?
How does Jesus feel about that?
Yeah.
He's got, I wasn't good enough for the first time. I'm covering up Mariah Carey.
Do you think he'll cover up Jesus next whenever he breaks up with him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
What's up with that mohawk, too? Is Nick Cannon trying to be a badass?
I think we're going calling this faux hog. There's no such thing as mohawk anymore.
The sides are completely shaved, though.
Yeah, but it's a transition to the rest of the hawk.
Okay.
You see?
Yeah, and it's not shaved, though. You still see his hair. That's technically a faux hawk.
Okay.
Definitely. But in the end... The moral of the story is he got to fuck Mariah. Yeah. Nobody else did. One up.
Would you get that back tattoo if you got to fuck Mariah?
I would let my mom take naked pictures of me getting tattooed on my back to fuck Mariah Carey one time. But, you know, that's me. Anyway, what else? Besides Seventh Heaven, there should be...
You see that video, though, of Mariah Carey singing that rehearsals, and it was completely off-key, and everyone was laughing at her for being so bad.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
He divorced her immediately.
Yeah.
We got some pregnant chick.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, Blake Lively. She made headlines this week by announcing her pregnancy with a picture. She released the picture of her bloated gut. And we all assume that there's a child in there that belongs to Ryan Reynolds, Van Wilder himself.
But maybe she just had some Chinese food, huh?
But I'm assuming she probably just finished the Chipotle burrito.
Some sweet and sour chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Definitely sweet and sour. You can look at that picture and tell it's got that orange tint to it.
Oh, yeah. She poured that sauce all over herself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And hey, I think you're on to something. I mean, I do the same thing. Every time I, like, eat a large, kind of push the belly out.
Have you seen the dude that took... Did we talk about that on here? The dude that took maternity pictures?
No, we didn't talk about that.
Yeah, that's a new trend now. Men taking maternity pictures, just extending their gut and taking photos like this, beautiful, tasteful pictures like this.
So who's Blake Lively?
She's, I don't even know if I could tell you a movie she's been in. She
just married Ryan Reynolds, right?
She's a hot Hollywood.
Oh, she's an actress?
Yeah, she's an actress. Okay. And she's married to Van Wilder.
Yeah.
She's going to have his baby, or she's going to shit out dinner. One I think we'll find out somewhere in the next week.
Yep.
Next week's headline will be.
Is that how you're going to release your pregnancy or let the world know about whenever you're pregnant?
By taking a shit and taking a picture of it?
Uh-huh.
No, that's not how I'm going to do it.
No.
No.
Because it probably had the bowl in there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Anytime there's blood in the stool.
Isn't that what the CDC is saying?
Are we down to the main event? Is there nothing left but Seventh Heaven?
Tell
me there's nothing left.
Yeah.
Okay, this was a long one. You're going to have to, like, if you can, like, zoom in,
And it's like a thumbnail, so when I...
It's going to be bad quality?
Yeah.
That's all right. We can live with this.
Okay.
So you guys heard about the Seventh Heaven dad, right? He tried to suicide himself today, was the story, and he's a pedophile.
Yep.
That's pretty fucking crazy.
He was a good Christian minister on that show.
On the show.
And I saw him promoting. No, that was Kevin Sorbo.
You know who else used to be a Christian? I just found out Jedi on the show.
Oh, yeah. Right. Used to be, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I took World Religion and found out we're all being scammed.
So this is famous TV dads.
Yeah.
I'm calling out Carl from, what is that, Family Matters? I demand to know what he's hiding.
That smile, though.
Exactly. What is he hiding?
Behind Ebola. He's got Ebola.
Seventh Heaven dad, you know, he was a pedophile.
Uh-huh.
The Brady Bunch dad, he was AIDS'd up. He was gayed up.
Yep.
He was super gay and died with AIDS in his blood. Secretly.
Carl's patient one. He caught the Ebola first.
Incredible. And then what was the other one? Bob Saget, half-baked. He admitted to us all that he sucked dick for coke.
Yep.
I demand to know what Carl's up to. Carl Jedi thinks he's got Ebola.
He's also a police officer, right? So he could be, you know, beating some people for
Did
no reason.
Did he shoot Michael Brown? Yeah. Hands up. Hands up, don't shoot, Carl.
Yep.
Hashtag hands up, don't shoot Carl.
Maybe if we had some more police officers like Carl Winslow, that wouldn't have happened, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's probably just a crackhead now.
What is he up to? You know who died is the dad from Fresh Prince is dead.
Oh, that's right.
Uncle Phil. He dead. Carl's next. What's he going to... He can't die from erotic asphyxiation so soon, though, because Robin Williams tried that. I think Robin Williams was trying that, and he didn't even get his pants off. He just, I think he was probably, he slipped while trying to get his pants down.
Yeah.
And accidentally took himself out.
Do y'all know this guy's real name?
Who, Carl Winslow?
Yeah, Carl.
Uh-oh.
It's Reginald Vell Johnson.
Yeah, that sounds right, from reading his name for years as a child. How many children has he pedophiled? Over the years.
I don't know, but the last...
Say on Wikipedia?
He's still working. He was in 12 Dog Days Till Christmas.
Oh, my God, how terrible.
That was his latest one.
12 Dog Days Till
Christmas.
He was
also in those Die Hard, or those Lethal Weapon movies? No?
Yeah.
What movie? Is it Lethal Weapon? Yeah. One of those cop movies he was in, yeah.
I know what you're talking about, yeah. He was like an auxiliary cop.
Yeah. Was his last day on the force, and he got... blown to hell.
Or was it just Turner and Hooch?
Maybe it was Turner and Hooch.
I think he was a common Turner and Hooch, wasn't he?
Sure.
Wow, he did a Funny or Die.
Do you have an IMDb?
Yeah.
Tell me he was in Turner and Hooch.
It wasn't Turner and Hooch, Chair.
Huh?
I'll bet you 10,000 Ebolas it wasn't Turner and Hooch.
All right, so he was in Ghostbusters.
Okay.
He was in Crocodile Dundee.
Wow.
Die Hard.
Die Hard, okay.
Die Hard, you nailed it.
Don't give me a bowl, sir.
Shit. Wait, you said... Yeah, he was in Turner
and Hooch. Whoop! Whoop! Yep. We were both right.
We're both right tonight.
The year before he was on TGIF, he was on Turner and Hooch.
Have you seen they're trying to do...
He was on 227, too. Yeah, I remember that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
You don't remember 227?
Jer's too young.
I don't know what that
is. It was a spinoff of Amen, I think.
Of what?
Amen.
Uh-uh.
No.
227, hell no.
No. Maybe Amen was a spinoff of 227.
Hmm.
It was one of the first urban sitcoms.
Oh, definitely don't watch those.
No.
Yeah, they were all like in an apartment building, a bunch of black guys and women. And...
Well, you have seen that. It was called Martin, right?
And they wanted to move
it. Was like Martin, but the 80s version.
Oh, it was called In Living Single, right?
They wanted to move up to that big house in the sky.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Different Strokes.
He was in Perfect Strangers, too.
Is that right?
As Carl Winslow. Wow.
That's funny.
That's that TGIF crossover.
Yeah. Right,
Balky was my favorite growing up. No?
Is that an ender?
No.
No.
I just didn't know if you knew who Balky was.
Everyone knows who Balky is.
Not everyone.
We're going to talk about them bringing back TGI.
That's what I just wanted to complain about. Now it's TGIT.
Uh huh.
Are they trying to do different days?
Ticket.
Huh?
TGI Thursday, yeah?
Yeah.
With the How to Get Away with Murder, Grey's Anatomy, and Scandal.
That's blasphemy to me.
Yeah.
The same way, you know, a Christian might take offense to them saying, thank God it's Friday.
Right.
I'm taking offense to them changing it from Friday to Thursday. It's Friday. There's no TGIT.
Nope. They ruined it, huh?
I think it's Saturday that they got rid of Saturday morning cartoons. Did y'all see that? Like, last Saturday was the last Saturday.
Yeah. On where?
I think it was the Vortex,
like, just
on
in
CW.
General?
Yeah.
Man.
No more Sonic the Hedgehog on Saturday mornings.
That's terrible.
No one. I don't know about y'all, but when I was a kid growing up, Saturday was known as Cartoon Day.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Total shame. Total ridiculous.
Kids now have no idea.
Total ridic. But listen, but that's because the kids get up and they're watching it on Netflix.
Yeah.
It's not like they're missing
out. Cartoon
Network.
Yeah.
My kids see so many effing cartoons, they're not missing out.
But it was scheduled on Saturday morning, Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yeah.
They used to have WWE Slam on Saturday morning.
I used to watch Superstars. Was it Superstar or Superstars?
Yep.
WWE.
Hosted by Todd Pettengale.
Todd Pettengale, sure. Yeah. Watched all that. Saturdays, that's a magical day for a kid, as a kid.
Not anymore, though, it seems like, huh?
It's just another day.
Yep.
I used to get up all the time, every Saturday, and put on Batman, Michael Keaton, VHS.
You wouldn't watch Batman the Animated Series on Saturdays?
No.
Or the X-Men cartoon?
And I'll fast forward. I watched the X-Men cartoon. I never liked it, but I would watch it because it was on.
Yeah. Dude, I think Michael Keaton is one of the best Batmans. However, I just read an article where he could care less about Batman.
Wow, good for him,
Didn't follow any of the Batman. He's like, I just did the role. I don't know anything about Batman.
But that's good for
serious,
him.
Though? I mean, come on. It's almost
It would be much more sad if he was still going around, like, trying to remind people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm the best Batman.
He has Beetlejuice, too. I think Beetlejuice, probably.
No, he definitely has a career. The Batman speaks for itself. He doesn't have to defend that.
You know, he's doing that new Birdman movie where he kind of parodies the Batman character.
I know what you're talking about. That looks very strange.
It does, yeah.
That's a very strange-looking movie.
Yeah. Reminds me of the Wrestler.
Oh, yeah.
Something kind of like that.
A washed-up actor.
Yeah, he's down and out. That's a weird-looking movie.
Yeah.
Who's behind that?
Kind of meta. I don't know who's
well, because it opens up where he's like floating in air, and you're like, whoa, this is going to be cool. And then like 30 seconds later, you're like, well, I don't know.
It's about the actor playing the superhero, yeah.
Did y'all see they're doing Beetlejuice 2?
I heard about that.
Yep. Everyone's
Keaton?
Confirmed,
Keaton's
coming back? All the cast.
Oh, good.
Cool.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Who else was in that? They had famous people, right?
Yeah, Winona Ryder. Alec Baldwin.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
And the chick. I don't know.
That'd be cool. I'll watch that. That'd be interesting to see the update. That's the new thing, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because I think about that. It's the same from people in the 90s to do a remake here in 2014, Beetlejuice or Dumb and Dumber. 20 years later, they're just picking it back up. Like, in the 70s, you know what I mean? Like, that was a time for a lot of people doing things. You know, but I just don't think the 90s were a time for, like, a new Cheech and Chong movie. They weren't, like, They weren't trying to rehash things. It seems like, for us, right. It seems like the 90s were yesterday.
Yeah, the aughts are definitely all about rehashing things.
And in the 90s, it seemed like the 70s were a lifetime ago.
Right.
But it's just funny. Like, it just seems like a day later, and we're still talking about all these fucking movies.
People say Hollywood's ran out of ideas, you know? It's just kind of a...
No, it hasn't.
Hey, what would be a good TV show series that y'all would like to see come back?
Oh, see, I don't believe in any of that stuff. I think...
Well, I just saw that they're redoing, or they're going to bring back Twin Peaks.
Okay. Uh-huh. Is David Lynch involved?
Yeah.
Okay.
And Frost. Both okay. of them.
Cool.
And the cool thing about that, because I've never watched Twin Peaks, but I saw that they were going to do it, and somebody was commenting that in one of the episodes, one of the main characters was like, "I'll see you in 25 years.
Oh, wow.
And now 25 years uh-huh. later, they're bringing it back.
That's wild. That's cool.
Yeah. Yeah. So I actually just went and downloaded the first two series, seasons of Twin Peaks. It's a pretty weird show. Yeah. Have you ever seen it?
I think I've watched the first episode.
Jer's a big David Lynch fan.
Yeah, I like David Lynch a lot. I haven't actually sat and watched that show.
What else has he done?
Movies.
Mulholland Drive, I think Jer likes
a lot of movies. Yeah. Mulholland Drive was very confusing.
Red Velvet or Purple Velvet or something?
Blue Velvet. David Lynch. What is that? Inland Empire.
He's also into that Transcendental Meditation, which is pretty cool.
Yeah,
I don't know if you ever got into that.
I do.
Yeah.
He's a TM. He's a big TM guy.
Yeah.
He's he's a very interesting guy. Don't search David Lynch rabbits on YouTube, because you'll never be the same again.
Uh-oh. Now we have to.
Doesn't make any sense whatsoever. But...
And when you're on YouTube, search "Happy Birthday" and then put your last put your name.
Okay.
And then see what pops up. Y'all want to see what y'all's do?
Sure.
Okay.
Never heard of this.
Have heard of this?
I haven't.
I have a brother-in-law who posts these videos every year, I think. Is it the robots?
Oh, you know what?
It's I don't know. I don't get it. Okay. All I know is when I'm popped up, when I did mine, I just get like a...
Well, Jedi is not
bunch
really
a bunch popular. Of goobers singing happy birthday.
What'd you search? Jansen?
Yeah.
Hmm. That's a funny thing. Yeah, that's right. I did see you got a random happy birthday, Eddie Donahue. I think it was even your full name. It was like some random Eddie Donahue
Eddie,
tribute
here's,
video.
Here's.
Oh, happy birthday, no. Eddie.
This isn't, I've never seen this before.
Well, you're just supposed to just like pick the first one that like pops up.
I wanna wish you a happy birthday.
they misspelled my name, actually.
I didn't even get your name right.
All right, so you get it. You get the point. And then I guess I'll do yours.
Is that the Bernstein Bears?
Jeremy, how do you spell your name, bro?
Jeremiah. Happy birthday to me.
All right, here's yours. Hold on.
There's an ad in front of yours.
I feel special.
Jeremiah, this song's for you. Happy
birthday. This is the greatest one I've ever seen. Wow, that's great. Alright, so yeah.
Is that same chicken that was in that Burger King commercial? The same chicken?
That might be the best video I've ever seen. That was awesome.
Y'all want to see what mine...
It's very weird. See, I don't have a common name. Like, my name isn't Eddie.
Well, I actually had one, though. I put mine in it, because I thought I was going to be, like, screwed.
Uh-huh, yeah. I guess Jansen's even more obscure than Jeremiah.
Isn't
that weird to hear your name? Like, the guy goes, "Happy birthday, Jeremiah." Like, when I hear Jeremiah, there's nobody else they're talking about but me.
Happy birthday to you.
See, this is all I get. Just a bunch of goobers.
Where's the chicken?
Happy birthday. I know. I don't get anything cool.
So it feels like people love you. Huh?
Why is that so funny to hear it?
But yeah, it's there you go.
I haven't had anyone sing happy birthday to me in about 10 years, so I definitely appreciated that, Jansen.
Damn. You're welcome. Yep. Yeah, Eddie's life is downward spiraling.
Yeah.
He's actually hoping for Ebola. It would be a bright side in his life.
Yeah, my life is bound to end up like Robin Williams, unfortunately.
It's a shame.
I'd be that lucky.
But we've all seen it coming for years.
Yep. Maybe I can go in for a throat procedure and not come out.
Do you not focus on, before we wrap this show up, let me get a little.
Because God knows it's time.
Let me get a little insight on your death. Because I am the noted death expert on the show. I'm obsessed with it. You don't ever sit around and think about how's it going to end? I mean, it's only going to end one way for you. One way.
Yeah.
And it's going to be it.
No, it's definitely going to be a car accident.
You think I would put my money on a car accident too. I'd like to, I guess, put this on the record that I think you'll die from a car accident as well. Oh. You're the worst driver I know.
Yeah.
You'll end up having the gun on the highway one day.
I get on the highway, sir.
And you'll have an 18-wheeler topple over you.
Yeah, and I won't be wearing a seatbelt.
And you will survive that.
Yeah.
Only to
be left in a coma for the rest of my life.
Catch Ebola.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I was trying to rhyme Ebola.
But yeah, I guess nothing rhymes with Ebola, huh?
Pensacola.
Yeah. When I move down to Pensacola, I'll get Ebola.
Nailed it.
Yep.
Speaking of nailed it, I think we nailed it. Episode 22.
In the books.
In the books. They'll be reading this one forever. In the future, any of the people who know how to read.
I'm worthy of creating a birthday wish on a machine like this. Eddie.
Yeah?
Here's wishing you a happy birthday. And many more to come.
Hey, thank you. You want to go back to my place?
Do you remember anything about the day he was born?
Oh, heavens, no.
Thank you, Grandma. That was Eddie's grandma. Incredible. She looked good.
Yeah, for 20.
Thank you. Come back and join us again.
It's a hot topic. Eddie and Jeremiah drop it like a hot pocket. Sports, the politics, and lunatics thinking they can run for president. Reality stars thinking they're heaven sent. Irrelevant.